do that, we're coming right in here, and then I want two knee strikes, just like this. So they look like this real quick. I got a front kick first. After the front kick, I want two palm strikes. After that, I clinch up, and I want two knee strikes, just like that. Okay? Person's going to throw the pad down. What are we doing when that happens? Person throws the pad down. Good. Go ahead, finger mesh right here. Other person picks up, and then the other person does it. Spread it out, please. We got plenty of room. We got a small class tonight. All right, let's give it a try. Set. Go. So how would you like to set this up?
So these guys, you're live already.
Oh, great.
Right there, look at that. There's people looking at you.
So, how you doing?
Hey, everybody. So I'm here at Phoenix Krav Maga in Anthem. And I'm putting my sneakers on. And this is Matt. He's the owner. I'm going to be doing weekly visits to gyms throughout the rest of the year, actually, and you guys are the first visit.
Cool.
So, in the background, you see these guys warming up. I have actually never done this. Actually, I've never done a martial art.
Cool.
I realized on the way here, tell everybody a little bit about what these guys are doing and about your studio.
Yeah, I mean, ideally what we do is we keep self-defense really, really simple, because in a, God forbid you ever get into a situation that you need to defend yourself, guess what? You need to make sure you make things simple, because your mind's not going to be able to really do anything complex. The second thing that we do is we make our workouts fun, so they are actually a workout. So you're kind of killing two birds with one stone. We go ahead and we learn some serious self-defense, but then we also get a workout at the exact same time.
So I've already done hot yoga today and legs.
So
tomorrow I won't be able to walk, but it's okay. All my isogenics after products will be really helpful tonight.
Right, right.
So this is the first, and so I just give you my injury. This shoulder's been rebuilt.
Okay.
This shoulder's a little triggered because of COVID.
Okay.
You know, I have arthritis in the joint.
Okay.
So like, I got to be real careful about that.
No problem.
You know, and I've got a short tendon tear.
Okay.
The reason why I'm sharing this with you is all you guys have excuses too, but I don't use mine to not do shit.
Exactly.
So I have torn LCL on the right side that is still kind of a little in.
Okay.
But other than that, what do I do?
Okay, great. So I'm going to grab a pad.
I'm excited.
Okay. We're going to go ahead. So we're going to kind of get right here. So first thing I'm going to have you do is what's called a front kick. So you're going to be in a good defensive stance. And I want you to go ahead and get this like that. So you're going to make contact with the laces of your shoes. You kick right up just like this. Perfect. Now I'm going to put a pad in front of you right here. Okay? Go ahead and try it real quick. Yeah, good. Do it again. Good. One more time. Perfect. Now.
You guys, if you're pissed off ever,
this is good stress. This is good stress reduction. So, hands are up. Knees are bent. Okay, right? And we kick one of the hands. Pop your back down. Yeah, good. Now, when you do it, raise your knee first and then flick out the bottom half of your leg. Yes. Perfect. Good. Do it one more time. Good. Take a break real quick. Time. Nice job.
That is super duper fun. I'm just telling you. I'm just telling you. That's fun.
I want you guys, when you guys are moving around with the pad, we're going to do palm strikes. So you guys will call it a number. Either 2, 4, 6, 8, or 10. Okay? So what that means is when Vicky moves around, she's going to hide and flash that pad. When she flashes it down, all right, she's going to go ahead and call a number. 2, 4, 6, 8, or 10. She's going to call?
4.
So I'm going to give you 4 palm strikes. All right, and when you guys do that, I want you guys pushing the partner across the room. Now, you guys don't have to go from wall to wall, but I want that person moving back as you're hitting. Even if it's just 2, so Vicky comes out and she throws me a kick right here, and I go ahead and throw 2, I want her moving back at least. Okay, all right? If it's 10, you obviously cover a lot more distance. Everybody got it? Same drill, nothing changes. The only thing that changes is when you throw the front kick right there, the person's gonna call that number and that's how many palm strikes you do. Okay? Same thing, throw the pad down, face smash, all that good stuff. You guys good? All right, let's give it a try. Set, go! So now, I want you to go ahead and you're gonna try to do 10 front kicks. Okay?
10 front kicks.
10, yeah, okay. So go slow, take your time.
Same leg?
Yep, same leg and everything. One, good. 2. 3, 4,
yep.
5, okay, you got it, 6, 7, 8, 9, palm strikes, so we're going to use the heel of our palm, straight out just like this, okay, so we always want to make sure we move in a straight line from our face or kind of jawline to the target. Okay. hold it against my chest right here. I want the pad to have some space. Okay. Go ahead. Yes. Good. Good. Good time. When you do it, you're doing pretty much the perfect thing right there. Working like combinations of two. So instead of just going one, waiting, two, you're doing the right thing. Going pop, pop, relax. Pop, pop, relax. Yes, yes, yes. And keep those hands up. Because the moment I drop my hands, I think what else? Right? So we're going to go pop, pop, and that's 1 second. We're going to do 5 minutes. Okay? All right, ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let's combo. Let's do a front kick and then palms up. Okay? Front kick. Palms. Yes! Front kicks. Palms. Good. Front kick. Palms. Front kick. Palms. One more. Front kick. Palms. Take a break.
Okay, I think I might have something more fun. This is hysterically fun. You guys gotta try this.
Nice job. You guys are doing a pretty good job. You know, something that we always say, and something I'm going, and by the way, Michelle, I'll talk more about this online or whatever. You might have heard an interview that I did with her several weeks ago, okay? She's just doing a little Facebook Live thing for us, so that's why she's in the corner. I'm kind of working with her. But something I was just talking to her about, when we do those palm strikes, remember, we're striking, we're always removing that, and we're taking that hand and coming right back to our face, okay? Why are we doing that? Yeah, okay. We want to protect what?
Feet.
Yeah, it seems common sense, but I can't believe how many people, once they strike, they drop their hands. They didn't even start up here, but once they hit, guess what those hands go? Right down here, right? Okay? So keep really, really compact. Really, really compact. The thing we don't want to be is, we don't want to be, you know, standing with our legs straight. We don't want to be with our hands down and moving around like a stick figure. We want to be down, crouched, and hitting and moving, hitting and moving. So I think most of you guys are doing a good job. We're going to do the exact same drill, okay? But now what I want you guys to do is we're going to go ahead and we're going to do a choke defense real quick. I only want you working with whatever choke defense I call out. The first choke defense we're going to do is our front choke defense. So I'm going to choke Stephanie real quick. So Stephanie's going to go over here. Our front choke defense, two hands right here. She's going to double hand pluck. Okay, and then she's gonna go ahead and she's kicking. Remember when we do this, guys, we're double hand plucking right here, chest goes out, shoulders go back. Okay, bash, okay, and we're just kicking. Now, if I'm close, it would turn into what kind of strike?
Knee.
If I'm farther away, it's gonna turn to what kind of kick? Good, front kick, right? Okay, just like that. So, let's go ahead and let's try it. Everybody stand up real quick. I just want you guys to review the front choke real quick.
Move it. Oops.
There we go. Okay. So, choke defense. There's different ways you can get choked. Okay. Obviously, from the front, okay, what we're going to do is if you're choking me, okay, you're going to take your hands and pull them across right here. I'm not wrestling with them because chances are someone's going to be bigger, stronger, things like that. Okay? So, what I'm not doing is I'm not going strength on strength. I'm using hands. So, when you're choking me right here, okay, the hands are going to be plucked outside because that's where it's the least amount of resistance is right here. Okay? So if you're here just like this, double hand pluck just like this. Okay? So we're going to... Yes, yes. So I want double hand pluck, front kick. Try that real quick with me, okay? So just stand regular. This is regular and all of a sudden we're choked. So double hand pluck, good, front kick. Good. Try it again real quick. Double hand pluck, front kick. Boom. One more time. Double hand pluck, front kick. You got it. Okay? So, give me 5 kicks just to keep that fresh in your mind. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Hand side. Good. 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 Double hand pluck. Pull those. No, no, no. Don't go to the inside. Go to the outside. Yes. Good. Now I'm going to go a little bit higher.
That's like totally counterintuitive because I'm thinking I should.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But watch this real quick. I'm going to go really, really. Go from the inside. Go from the inside. Okay? And what I want you to do is try to break your hold from the inside. No, from the inside, the first way you did, the wrong way. Yeah, go ahead. Now try breaking. Go harder, 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 harder. Good. Now, I'm going to hold on, same thing. Puck to the outside. As hard as I can. Do it again with you. Okay, all right?
See, because there's nothing standing in the way right there.
Right.
As long as my elbows are in, it's really hard to come to the inside. So don't so much pull, pluck real well.
Yeah.
Okay, so they're not
going to...
Sorry.
Yes. Okay, so watch. So go here. Pop. Okay, great. Yes. Now just don't kick me. Okay, go. Practice. Good. You're cool. Good. Kick. Boom. Good. Do it again. Good. Good. Boom. Real tight. Go. Yes. Good. Now put your hands down. I'll choke you. Do it. Good. Nice. Can you hop in real quick with her? Okay. So I'm going to have you go through front kick, two palm strikes. Okay. Teacher, one walk-in knee. And then a front choke. This is Kevin. He's one of my assistant instructors. And he's going to take you through the whole thing now that I'm doing it. Good. Fine.
Good.
That's
good.
Okay. Good.
So, I'm we're going to work that in. Drill, you guys usually know. Stephanie's going to pick the pad. She's going to move around. She's going to go ahead. She's going to front kick. Okay? She's going to call it a number.
Four.
Okay? I got two knees. She'll throw it down. One knee snap. She goes ahead and chokes. Then I go ahead. Do my moves right there. I pick it up and I start moving around. Okay? That make sense? Same thing as before, we're just working the front shoulder. Okay, let's give it a try. Run it up.
Full sequence or return?
Full sequence. Yeah. She knows front kick, she knows palm strikes, go over to a walk-in knee, okay, and then she knows the choke cuts.
Perfect.
Yep.
All right. So, same thing there. We're
going to
do is that walk-in knee there first?
Got a little step. Knee right on in, exactly. Good. Good.
Am I
should say keep the same thing there. Protect yourself now. You're kicking me out here, protecting that, and all of a sudden I'm getting knee on in.
Guys, she's been doing this for like 10 minutes, okay? She's doing really good.
Good.
Oh, nice. Like I said, I think those are your best kicks that I saw over there. That was really good.
I'm winded. Right. So much fun. So much fun. And if you're really super angry, this is the thing. I'm just telling you.
We're going to go ahead and we're going to do our bursting elbow strike. Okay, our bursting elbow strike. So Kevin's going to be in here just like this. When we do our bursting elbow strike, remember, we're at a distance. Okay, so I shouldn't be able to necessarily reach his tap. Bursting means I'm stepping on him as I elbow right here. So as I do this, I'm stepping on him just like this. Okay, ready? Many of you guys will either do this, just stay here, or you'll lean on in, and I didn't want neither. Watch my feet only. Both are moving on in, okay? All right, elbow strikes. First thing, elbow strikes, one side. Let's give it a try. Set, go.
Sorry.
Yep.
I guess a little bit. Right
in with the elbow? More so
steering it on? Hands up, guys, and start the thing.
Yeah, exactly. Cross. So we're timing that with the position of our feet as well. So what I like to do is we do a little step together. So we push on that back leg, we step with our front. Step up together. Step up. Step up. Step up. One. Now.
So do you mind my stronger leg?
Are you a righty or a left?
I'm a righty.
So I'm going to say you need your right back and you need your elbow and your back on. Exactly. Now we're going to add that step with the arm coming around the side. So we're going to step it up. Yeah, don't leave that foot back like you said. Bring the whole thing through.
Okay.
Yeah? One more time. Good. Now, tits up. Step in and out. Go on, go. Good.
Good time.
There we go. That was your best one, man. Just like that. Go.
Other side, first thing elbow strike. Go!
Here, protect yourself. Now fire. That's it. Good. Go. That's it. Hurts. Yeah, get a little bit more pad. Go.
See from the
camera. Bring that around just a little bit more on that. So as that step comes in.
Alright, time. Last little counter here. Kevin's gonna be right behind me. We're gonna do a low rear hammer. So from behind here, I'm gonna step off to the side, cover this side, hit. Okay, start here. When he taps me, just let me know he's ready. Cover, hit, just like this, okay? You're gonna do one side, the other side, then the other person picks up the pad. So what that means is, he taps, I go to one side, he taps, I go to the other side, he drops the pad, okay? I go ahead and I pick it back up, he turns around, does the exact same thing. One side, good. Other side, good, okay? I would throw it down. We're just working those real quick, all right?
You're just not going to throw the pad down.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to be holding.
Yeah.
All right.
You're doing the workout.
That's right. That's right.
Okay, so I'm going backwards.
Yep, so back there first. As soon as you feel me tap, that's when you step to the side. And just kind of like I'm going to a baseball bat. We're going to try both. So what first is so that you can line it up. And make sure that we're here. Behind here, so take a step to the left or the right. Okay. Now you're gonna hit with one arm. That's what's up. Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
So if you step to the other side, one arm. Yes. There we go. Ready? Wait for the tap. Tap. Tap one side. There we go. Oh, good. See how you're kind of coming across, getting the side right there? I like what you're doing. Once you come and tap, actually take a little step to the side there. So then hit with that. Step and drag. Kind of very similar to the elbow, yeah? You didn't know we'd be doing like electric slide. Okay. Tap step to the side. Good. 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 Yeah. That's it. See, that creates it. Yep.
Alright.
Gotcha.
There's all kick and boodle. Kevin's gonna be over here. He's gonna tap me on one or the other sides. So if he does this side, that means I'm just going down to this side, hitting. From there, I'm turning around. He's gonna put that pad down. What does that mean? Front kick. He's gonna call a number.
Two.
Okay. One, two, always end with a bursting elbow. Okay, clinch on up, give me two knee strikes. If he throws it down, I face him, he chokes. However he wants, one of those three, right? I go ahead and I do that move. I pick it up, go to his back, do the exact same thing. I'll say it all over again. It's a lot of stuff. You guys ready? Okay, so from here, he taps me, okay? Taps me on this side, so I'm gonna cover, hit, turn around, front kick, calls the number, 2, 4, 6, or 8.
Four.
Good, 1, 2, 3, 4, always ending with what? Bursting elbows, good. Two knee strikes. He throws the pad down, okay, as I smash, he chokes, whatever choke he wants, I go ahead and I pick it up and I do the same attempt. All right. Last stand-up drill of the day, and we're going to hit the ground. You guys ready? Set. Go.
Did you get all that? Okay. Ready? Nice and slow there. First, go ahead and tap the other back. I'm going to tap one shoulder that I want you to do. So if I tap this side, you're going to step that way, then if I tap this side, got that favorite kick of yours, then. So, front kick, two, two palms there. Whoop, now we have the elbow. So, first, I call that number. I do two, elbow. I'm going to do that step on the knee. Step in, good. Up there, smash that pad.
So these guys are at an anthem. So if you come off of up 17, if you're coming from Phoenix on 17 North, you get off on exit 229, over where actually Anthem Harley Davidson is, Buddy Stubbs, and you're gonna take a left and then a left onto Opportunity Way, and they're down here in the corner, okay, by Vision Way. So I'm gonna let Matt talk a little bit more about what this is all about.
Hey, listen, instead of just talking what's about, I'll tell you about something we have coming on up that's really, really important.
Oh, yay.
October 24th, where October is actually Domestic Violence Awareness Month, and so we're doing a free female self-defense seminar.
This awesome.
That's gonna be held, once again, on Saturday, October 24th. And it's going to be from 11 until noon.
Cool.
And if you guys are interested, we'll go ahead and we'll probably post this on your site somewhere.
100%.
We'll put a website up and a phone number. But if you guys have any questions, you guys can feel free to go ahead and text or call me at 623-300-6114. And I'll hand it over to Michelle.
Awesome. So I think I might have something happen on the 24th, but if I don't, I'm definitely going to be here. And I'm going to post this on all my women's, in all my women's groups and also all my women's bikers groups. So if you want to try something different, that's super fun. This is hilarious. I was a little nervous actually, because I've never done any kind of fighting before and my shoulders are kind of funky, but you know, this has been awesome. So if you're looking for something different, try this. Okay, guys, I'll be doing a visit from a different gym every week for the next 12 weeks or so until the end of the year. And so tune in. If you come on up and you see Matt, tell him that Michelle sent you from Relentless Talk Radio. Have a good night, guys. I'm going to go do the cardio part. Take care.